So you're thinking of doing an electronic live set and you want to bring a drum computer, a sequencer or maybe a sampler to the stage and you do not know where to start? I have got 6 tips for you and let's start with that right now. Hey gang, I'm Analog Kitchen. Thanks for checking out another video. If this is your first time here, click subscribe and hit the notification bell so you miss nothing. 6 tips to start your electronic live set. If you look at Behringer, if you look at Akai, if you look at Novation, brands are just making these synthesizers and it's all cool, but where to start? But before you pick your piece of gear, that's one thing you need to take into consideration first. Tip number one, I would suggest that you find out who you are as an artist. Who do you want to be? I mean, if you're more of a melodic person, then probably you will end up buying more synthesizers. But if you're more of a drummy kind of person, you want to do more percussive stuff, then I would suggest to just look at the drum computer a little bit more. And maybe you just want to be a hybrid person, you want to just do everything together. You might work with sequences more. So find out who you are, because the thing is, it will leave you with a more convincing and compelling performance on stage, which in turn limits all the errors, and you will make errors on stage. And the best thing for you to do is to know who you are in order for the crowd and your fans to figure out who you want to be as an artist. Which leads me into tip number 2, think out of the box. So you finally figured out what kind of equipment you want to work with after watching a million gazillion tutorials online, and now you're up on stage. You might end up hammering away on your equipment, trying to figure out what all the functionality is, looking for that nice big wash of reverb or the filters, where are they? Cool for you now that you mastered your piece of kit, but does it really look that compelling to your crowd? Do your fans actually like what you're doing? Because the thing is, it's a live performance, which means it's entertainment, right? So in the end of the day, the last thing people would like to see is you standing there like a robot. Be interactive with your crowd. When you need to work on your equipment, you look at it. I mean, you're an electric live performer, which means you have to perform, but you're an entertainer too as well, and that means you have to entertain. Which leads me to tip number 3. And that is create a musical backup. You're working with analog equipment. The reason you're doing this live set is because you probably don't want to work with a laptop computer, but if you have to rank up against the chart topping, plug-in infested hits that are out there at the moment, you might have to think of something else. Make sure that it's very pleasing for your fans to see what you are doing. So creating a musical backup is actually very important. Make it so that you work on a computer as well, so you have the best of both worlds. What I like to do as a hybrid musician, I'll make the samples in my computer, I'll whiz them over to the live set, and then I structure how I'm going to do my things. Some things are there just for sequencing, but other things are there just to fire off, whether it be white noise, whether it be a vocal effect, whether it be a snippet or just a piece of a bass line that I can actually play. As long as I'm trying to keep it interactive, it will work. And that musical backup gave me a lot of freedom. It eliminated a lot of insecurities. Tip number 4, think ahead. A lot of people forget to actually think on what the sound system is going to be like, because the chances are it's going to be different every which way you go. You go to one club, it sounds differently from a different club. So thinking ahead on what you are actually going to perform live on stage and how you're going to sound is a big thing, right? So the bass drum needs to be like spot on the money. Same as your bass lines. Have synthesizers that got a wide variety of transients so that it will fill the room, and keep it simple. Don't oversaturate your productions with too many tracks, because the more tracks you have, the more the sound system has to work. And if a club is not up the par, you will sound like, you know what I mean, and that's not cool. Keep it simple as possible. Bass drum, bass line, clap, hi-hat, one sound, and you move it gradually into the room. And from the minute you start to feel that the room is accepting you, that's when you can actually work with your crowd and just do more stuff. Number 5, it's also very important to master your gear, because if you can find out that your equipment can do something else than has been descripted in the manual, it gives you a unique selling point and it will make you stand out as a live performing artist, because there are so many people trying this live thing. Everybody sounds different, but not a lot of people stand out in a way that leave a lasting impression. And I think that that's what you want, because that's what you can do. If your sound is analog and you bring the best sounding sound to the stage, because everything you're doing is not compressed, it's not being over equalized, that means that you've got a unique selling point right there already. I've seen a lot of performances where people are on stage and they just bought that piece of kit. Now that they have it, it needs to come on stage. Maybe you can look at your equipment as building a team. And in that team, all the players need to be up to par, right? My sixth and final point, break the code. By breaking the code, I mean you read the manual, you figure out what the sweet spot of your sequencer, synthesizer, or drum computer is, and see if you can break the code. If you have a bass synthesizer, but you don't play any bass notes with it because it works in a different frequency range, better for your sound, that will give you a unique selling point. If you got drum sounds that can actually play melodies, try that. Break the code and think out of the box for yourself. Don't limit yourself to think like, I can't do this or I cannot do that, because in the end of the day, there's more that you can do. But the fun part of performing live is you don't know what's going to happen. You'll do something, the crowd picks up on it, and it's always something unexpected. Well, thanks. That's it for today. If you thought that this was entertaining or informative at all, don't hesitate to click subscribe and also hit the notification bell so you will not miss out on anything. Peace, I'm Analog Kitchen, and I'll catch you next time.